Hello everyone. Welcome to Physics Laboratory under social distancing period. Today we gonna learn about the experiment 7 that is constructed ohmmeter, voltmeter and ammeter. We have 4 parts for this experiment. First of all, I gonna introduce the device. The first important device is galvanometer. Look at galvanometer. You know when the current pass through galvanometer, the needle of galvanometer is deflected. Under high current, the needle is deflected angle. But under small current, deflected angle is small too. This experiment, we use galvanometer as the display. Move to the next device is digital multimeter. In physics lab, we use digital multimeter to measure the current, resistance, and potential difference. For digital multimeter, we use LCD as the display. But today, we use galvanometer as a display, not LCD. And sure, we can control galvanometer by the current. If we want to use galvanometer as a display, we need to know the important parameter for galvanometer. You know galvanometer has the internal resistance that we call RG. For the past one, we need to measure internal resistance of galvanometer RG. And then we need to find the maximum current that pass through galvanometer that do not damage on a galvanometer. The current should be smaller than the maximum current that we call IG, full scale current. So in the part one, we have 4 steps to do the experiment. First, we need to measure RG. We use a digital multimeter to measure internal resistance of galvanometer RG. If we want to measure internal resistance of galvanometer, we need to move the pointer of a digital multimeter to omega. It means ohmmeter mode. We need to connect the galvanometer to digital multimeter. We connect the negative pole of galvanometer to COM or common pole of digital multimeter, and positive pole of galvanometer connect to omega pole of digital multimeter. It means if you move the pointer to omega, you connect to omega terminal. This is the method that measure RG, internal resistance of galvanometer by digital multimeter. Then we move to next step. We have to connect the circuit to find IG, the full scale current of galvanometer. I told you, if you want to construct voltmeter, ohmmeter, and ammeter, you need to know the full scale current of galvanometer. And then you need to connect the circuit to control I, the current, pass through galvanometer. And then we can find full scale current of galvanometer. Look at the circuit. We have the symbol of G in the circle and RG. These are the symbol in the square line we call a galvanometer. If we want to adjust the current, we need to connect galvanometer to RS in series. And you can see this device. This device is a series resistor that we call RS. This is variable resistor that you can adjust the resistance by using this knob. We have the knob of 10,000, 1,000, 110. For example, the value of resistance is 12,000, 380. We can adjust the resistance by using the knob. And then we use RS connect in series to a galvanometer to adjust the current, to decrease the current. And then we connect the circuit to battery. This battery can see the pole of battery, the positive pole and negative pole. You can control the direction of current by the pole of battery. And this is the symbol of battery. The current flow from the positive pole of battery to RS and galvanometer, and then flow back to the negative pole of battery. You need to adjust the variable resistance RS by using the knob of the resistance, and then you adjust until the needle of galvanometer exactly indicate to the final line of galvanometer. It means the current flow in the circuit is IG. And if you want to calculate IG, you can use Ohm's law. V equal to IR. I think you have ever seen this relation. The current is IG and resistance is total resistance RT. R total should be RG plus RS. Then you can find IG from V over RT. I mean IG equal to V divided by RG plus RS. And from this relation, you can find current, full scale current IG. And how do you know potential difference of battery from the circuit? You need to use a digital multimeter and adjust to be a voltmeter mode to measure potential difference of battery. You can use this one digital multimeter and move the pointer to V of bar. It means voltmeter mode in direct current. We use V of bar for this experiment because this is a direct current circuit. And then we can measure potential difference of battery. And when you know the potential difference of battery, you put in the value of the number on and the relation, you can calculate IG full scale current. When you know the internal resistance RG and the full scale current IG, there are the important parameter of galvanometer, and then you use the parameter RG and IG for the next part. And this is galvanometer, and we used galvanometer as a display to construct voltmeter, ohmmeter and ammeter. Okay, right now we move to demonstration for this experiment. Okay, right now I gonna introduce the device that we want to are used in the first part. This is galvanometer, and we use galvanometer as a display. If you want to find RG, you need to use a digital multimeter to measure the internal resistance of a galvanometer. Move the pointer to omega symbol. Right now, digital multimeter is ohmmeter mode. We connect the wire to measure the internal resistance of galvanometer. Connect the negative pole of galvanometer to common terminal COM of digital multimeter, and then connect positive pole of galvanometer connect to omega symbol terminal of digital multimeter. Remember, move to omega symbol, connect to omega symbol terminal. And then you can see this number is an internal resistance of galvanometer. It is 144.1. And this is internal resistance, RG. Okay, next, I'm gonna try to test the current that flow to the galvanometer, connect directly of a battery to galvanometer to test it. Negative pole of battery connect to negative pole of galvanometer, and positive pole of galvanometer connect to the positive pole of battery. Try to touch the positive pole to a positive pole of battery. You can see the needle move over a final line. The needle move over a final line. It means if you connect to positive pole of battery, you damage the galvanometer. You cannot directly connect to battery because the current is greater than full scale current. You can damage galvanometer. It means if you want to find full scale current IG, you need to decrease the current flow through galvanometer. I mean, you have to use the other device, I mean RS, to decrease the current flow in the circuit. We have galvanometer with 30 division full scale current. It means the needle move to the exactly final line of galvanometer. We need to connect RS in series to galvanometer. Connect positive pole of galvanometer to the pole of RS. You know RS, it means series resistor that we connect to the galvanometer. Another pole of RS we connect to positive pole of battery, and negative pole of galvanometer connect to negative pole of battery. And then you can see this is a series connection. All device connect in series. You can see the current flow from the positive pole of battery flow to RS and then flow to galvanometer. You can see the needle is deflected and then the current flow from galvanometer back to the negative pole of battery. If you want to adjust the current flow in the circuit and the needle of galvanometer move to final line full scale at 30 division, we can adjust by using the knob. We start with the biggest number of resistance of RS, move the knob to number 9, because under the biggest resistance keep the small current flow in the circuit. We start with 10,000 knob. We turn the knob to the lower number and you can see the needle is deflected. It means the current is flow. Next, we adjust 1,000 knob. Turn it and you see and the needle move over the final line. You need to turn it back and next turn 100 knob. Turn the knob until the needle indicate to exactly the final line, and then turn the turn up to adjust it. Can you see right now? The needle indicate to exactly the final line. The needle indicate to number 30. This is full scale current flow in the circuit. You can read the resistance from resistance box. Look at the resistance box. The value of resistance is 1410. Again, 1410 ohm. And this is RS. You can read from the resistance box. Right now, you know RG from the measurement and read RS from resistance box. Record on your worksheet. Record RS 1410 ohm. You got RG. You got RS. The last parameter that you need to know to calculate the current, full scale current, is potential difference of battery. We use digital multimeter to measure the potential difference of battery. At digital multimeter, we move the pointer of digital multimeter to V of bar. It means right now it is ohmmeter mode. We connect common terminal to a negative pole of battery and another pole of battery, a positive pole of battery, connect to V of digital multimeter to measure potential difference of battery. You can see a voltmeter. We connect voltmeter in parallel to a battery to measure potential difference of battery. You can see the number. This is a potential difference of battery. It is 1.472 volt. Right now you got all parameter. You can calculate full scale current IG from the relation. We know V, potential difference. We know RG from measurement. We got RS from resistance box. We can find IG. When we know RG and IG, we can construct voltmeter, ohmmeter, and ammeter for next part. I would like to finish the experiment part number one. Don't forget to continue with the second episode. Thank you.